Bacteria are microorganisms that can live pretty much everywhere. Although some of them can cause diseases, many others produce useful compounds for our everyday life. And thanks to the scientific advances made in the last decades that allow to read and modify genetic information, now researchers can engineer organisms with new features and expand the catalogue of compounds they can produce. But when we want these bacteria to generate high quantities of products at an industrial scale, things get a little harder. This happens because the genes we introduce to recreate new pathways and generate products are not alone inside the bacteria. They have to compete for room and resources with all the many other metabolic reactions, and this lowers the efficiency. Also, sometimes, these genes can interfere with other important reactions for the bacteria, and can even be toxic or lethal for the microorganisms, truncating the possibility of generating these compounds. But what if we could physically separate reactions inside the bacteria and avoid these problems? This is the aim of Rafts for Biotech, a project that exploits a recently discovered compartment in bacteria, lipid rafts. These rafts are membrane regions with a specific lipid and protein composition, where specific cellular reactions are confined. Thus, if we target the desired reactions into rafts, the synthesis of molecules of interest will be enhanced by avoiding interferences with the bacterial metabolism and by preventing the dispersion of toxic molecules towards the rest of the cell. To do this, the Raft for Biotech project will use novel bioinformatic techniques to identify the best ways to design these compartments. Then, in the laboratory, artificial rafts will be engineered and studied in two different microorganisms, Bacillus subtilis and Escherichia coli. This technology will then be scaled up and transferred from the lab to big industrial bioreactors to test its efficiency and versatility in three study cases. The production of antibiotics for medical purposes, vitamins for the cosmetic industry, and the degradation of pollutants present in food industrial processes. This approach could be applied to any biotechnological process in the future, and thus it will boost the competitiveness of the European biotechnology industry. Visit www.raftsforbiotech.eu to follow our progress.